crush a bit, little bit, roll it up, take a hit, feeling lit, feeling like 2 a.m. summer night. I don't care, hand on the wheel, driving drunk, I'm doing my thing, rolling the mid beside and now, living my life, getting our dreams.
It's not liquid, I thought it was like gonna be like liquid, and it was like solid and chunky. Yeah, I think I swallowed some, and I don't know, got some Oreo in there.
If I die, know I lived it to the fullest. If I fall, if I die, know I lived and missed some bullets. I'm on the pursuit.
Like that, we got to meet new people and make new friends.
Dumping water all over Will.
I got better at my BP skills.
My arms hurt.
I think it was great. I was disappointed that I didn't get to dance, but I did get pizza. So, we look good.
Like, I need
how
to buy
feel?
One. Because I'm doing a lot of reel like shots
went,
now.
I feel like that went fantastic, except really? It's 9, so I mean, we're going till 10 at this point. But we're doing great.
Tell me what you know about the night terrors every night. 5 a.m. cold sweats waking up to the sky. Tell me what you know about dreams, dreams. Tell me what you know about night terrors, nothing.
I don't get my dreams shattered though.
You're very weird.
My face is shattered.
I'm going to drink.
Yep.
My role was the drunk driver. I decided that I was okay to go out and drive and that I wasn't bad enough to where I couldn't drive. And I went on a beer run, and that was my role.
I was one of the more irresponsible kids of the group. I was gone. I had a lot to drink that night, and thankfully for my friends, they took care of me, put me in the car. But I was very irresponsible, didn't make any decisions myself, and I had to pay the price for it.
I had a really emotional drunk girl that had friends that left her, and she was trying to make a strict curfew because of her parents. And then, you know, she gets asked if she needs a ride. She takes it willingly. I put someone else's life at risk when I let him get in the car with me and take me home, and then we got in that accident.
Just how you, like, any little thing you do now can affect you the rest of your life. And not only your life, but others. It's just a domino effect. Even people, like, for me, I just had a drink or two in this scenario, and I had to pay my own life for, like, Lizzie's mistakes. That's just something that you need to take into consideration when you decide to get behind a wheel and drink.
It helped me kind of finally realize how much things can change in such a little time. It doesn't really hit you until you kind of experience it yourself. And this was an outlet. In a blink of an eye, everything can change in your life. If I would have worn my seatbelt, I probably would have lived.
Well, when we got in the ambulance, I had to stay in the character. And I was unconscious. And it was hard for me because the medic was going through like a guy who was actually unconscious. I heard my mom start crying and my dad start crying before they even got into the room to do. But I stayed there. When they got there, they cried for about 5-10 seconds, and then I couldn't do it anymore. It was too much for me, and it was way too much for them, so I had to give them a hug right then and there. Even though I was all bloodied up and crusty and sticky, disgusting, I just had to do it, because I mean, that's just a hard experience for my parents to do.
Obviously, not every party is going to end in a drinking and driving accident, but that's only if we can really implement what the program speaks about, and that's stopping drinking and driving. So it definitely makes you think about where you are and why you're there and what could happen from it.
It's 1:17. Still at school. My render just finished. My whole team's asleep. The suspenseful music is playing in the background.
Honestly, it's less than I thought it'd be.
Jack, what time is it?
1:48 a.m.
What are we waiting for?
The video shows in less than 8 hours, and we're just exporting it. It says 1 hour and 22 minutes, and I really don't want to be here until 3 a.m. No. But that's just me.
Neither does Mr. Burnett.